First at 6, Central Texas schools are taking new steps to sanitize surfaces and minimize the risk of spreading germs.
These are additional cleaning measures above and beyond the usual flu protocols in response to concerns about the Wuhan coronavirus. KXAN's Caitlin Carmoot looks at what local school districts are doing and what they're teaching children about the virus.
Raise your hand if you've heard of the coronavirus. Yeah, today we're going to do some activities with you.
A sea of kindergartners are learning all about the virus that's been floating around.
And this is how it attacks the cell.
Achoo!
Taught by older students at this Harmony Charter School, they're not just learning about how to wash their hands, but also the science behind the virus.
Now let's color a diagram of what the coronavirus looks like.
Meanwhile, local public schools are instructing staff instead. Austin ISD sent out a sanitation memo to its transportation department saying in light of the spread of the coronavirus and flu season, the district bought antimicrobial services to be used on all of its buses and their bases. The treatment process combines fogging, spraying, and misting with high-power disinfectants. Neighboring Round Rock ISD is fogging campuses with Razor, the same antimicrobial coating AISD purchased. They say they're also using Quat. That's a hospital-grade disinfectant for places like restrooms. Pflugerville is also taking its own measures using an EPA-registered germicide that it says is effective against the coronavirus. Custodians there change vacuum filters daily to remove airborne particles and use electrostatic spray technology to cover large common areas with Purell surface sanitizer. Leander ISD says it's using similar electrostatic sprayers to disinfect classrooms. They also are in contact with district nurses, and they identify broken soap dispensers. Caitlin Carmoot, KXAN News.
And we also reached out to neighboring school districts to see if attendance is down. Round Rock, Georgetown, and Leander ISDs all say no.
And it is the time of the year when colleges are sending out acceptance letters, so we reached out to local higher institutions of learning to see whether the coronavirus is impacting their admissions. St. Edward's University says the majority of their incoming students will not arrive until August, so it's too soon to speculate. Austin Community College says there's nothing extra required for students seeking admission who've been in impacted areas. And as for students returning from places with travel advisories, both UT Austin and Texas State are requiring staff and students to self-isolate for 14 days before returning to their campuses.